Good morning, my dear friends, colleagues, students, teachers, all the participants from all over India. We have reached today towards the second day of our program, that is application of SPSS in social science research. Today is the last day of our program. We as convener of this program, Dr. Shyamashree Sood, Assistant Professor and Head, Department of Education, Chidhanyat Mahavidyalay, I invite one and all to our program. On behalf of our respected, beloved Principal Ma'am, Dr. Uma Ghosh, who is not present today, I greet all the participants and the presenter and all the support, technical supporters and all of them in our program. Today, we have received, very fortunate to receive, a potential person in research area. He is none other than Dr. Amol Bhutia, Professor, Department of Commerce, University of Kalyani. Thank you, sir, that he managed time for us from his busy schedule. So, before deliberation of his lecture, I want to introduce Dr. Amolendu Bhuiya.
Hello.
Hello, sir. Let me introduce you first, then I will invite you, sir.
Okay.
Dr. Amolendu Bhuiya is Professor, Department of Commerce, University of Kalyani, Nodia, West Bengal, India. He has published 108 research articles and 8 books in his national and international repute. He has completed 4 research projects. His research interests are in the financial markets, corporate finance, international finance, and behavioral finance. He has presented 52 research papers in various international and national conferences. He served as an editor-in-chief of American Journal of Theoretical and Applied Business, USA, for 2 years. Now, he is an editor-in-chief of Indo-Asian Journal of Finance and Accounting. Presently, he is serving as a member of the editorial board in 21 international journals. Dr. Bhuiya acted as a keynote speaker in 36 national and 6 international or foreign conferences. So, dear participants, you can easily understand what a rich career he had. So, we are quite fortunate to have him among us. Now, I would like to invite our respected sir, Dr. Amolendu Bhuiya, to focus in this research area. Sir, please, over to
okay,
you.
Okay, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good morning to everyone and respected principal, Siddhinath Mahavidyalay, Purva Medinipur. And respected coordinators of the particular 2 days webinar, Dr. Shyamashree Sood, HOD, Department of Education of Siddhinath Mahavidyalay, Dr. Shima Roy, Dr. Mohua Basu Mallik, Dr. Reshma Khatun, or different staff of the particular college. And
sir, they are not from our college, sir. They are participants.
Okay,
but they are not from our college.
What I have seen in the gallery view. Okay.
They are participants, sir. Actually, okay, Dr. Pratita Bishas, Madam, HOD and Associate Professor, School of Education, Adamas University. She is in she is helping us actually, sir.
Okay. Dr. Prakriti Bishwas.
Prarthita.
Okay, Prarthita Bishwas.
Yes.
Okay, from Adamas University. And different staff, teachers of Siddhinath Mahavidyalaya. And dear participants, all across India. And again, thanks for inviting me to act as an invited speaker in today's webinar on the title entitled Delegation of Research. What I have selected for discussion today, this is exploratory factor analysis. Before going to the topic, I want to say something about pandemic, COVID-19. COVID-19 is basically affect the education sector, including the society and economy. And the COVID-19, I want to say, has extensively disturbed the education sector, which is significant determinant of any country's prospect. Obviously, the current pandemic affects the teaching and learning more directly, and the whole world, including India, has not been ready for this challenge. Most of the teachers have taken for idea to change to an online mode with what instrument. And because we are in the e-learning environment, we are in the virtual learning environment, teachers devotedly have taken the front position in this teaching and learning mode. And in time of the pandemic, by making comfortable and student motivated groups in social media using new technologies, say different softwares. Today, the college has used Zoom software. There are lots of software have been used by different colleges, universities, schools for the purpose of online teaching and learning. But India is not ready to face the particular challenge, because I have some data about 9% of the students, including schools, college and universities, have TV and computer or laptop. And about 16%, just more than 16%, have internet facilities. and near to 35% have a smartphone. This is a real challenge to us to identify which factors affecting the education sector. And for the purpose of identification, I have selected exploratory factor analysis. How would you identify the particular or important variables which can be affected the education sector during the pandemic time? At the same time, behavior of the students have been changed, because most of the college and school students actually use the particular smartphone, who have a smartphone, not only for education, they have used for some games, etc. That means actually the education sector has been disrupted because of the pandemic COVID-19. Therefore, it is a high time to identify which variables affect the Indian sector, Indian education sector. But today's discussion, how do you identify? But which factors, I do not, I won't make any comment on that. But how will you apply for the identification of exploratory, identification of variables, and also some latent variables, means unobserved variables, including the latent factors. Therefore, I want to use exploratory factor analysis for the purpose of exploratory factor analysis, for the purpose of identification of observed variables, significant and important observed variables, and important unobserved variable, which is called the latent variable. Okay. I have a problem, because when I am sharing the particular content, means PPT, my video will be stopped. Therefore, you have not to face my face. You have not to face my face. Therefore, I please allow me to share the PPT. Yeah. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Is it clear? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, exploratory factor analysis. Today, I want to discuss why use exploratory factor analysis, when to use exploratory factor analysis, and thereafter, how will you determine the important variables through exploratory factor analysis, and also how will you identify the latent factors, and thereafter the interpretation of the particular results, what you have
what we will get from the SPSS software. Also, if time is permitted, I want to share how will you calculate manually, then to understand, for so that you can understand what is happening in exploratory factor analysis. Exploratory factor analysis is basically a family of multivariate statistical methods that attempts to identify the smallest number of hypothetical construct that can parsimoniously explain the covariation observed among a measured means observed variables. In other words, I can say to identify the common factors, say for example, latent factors are assumed to be unobservable characteristics of people, which are manifested in differences in the scores attained by those respondent on the measured variables. What is meant by the term, say for example, what is meant by the term factor? A factor is an unobservable variable. I have already mentioned the term latent variable that influences more than one observed variable and that accounts for the correlation among these observed variables, observed measures. I can say in another way, the observed measures, observed variables are interrelated because they share a common cause. If the latent construct mean the unobserved variable is partitioned out, the interrelations among the observed variables will be zero. Therefore, I can say exploratory factor analysis is used to receive insight into the structure of underlying processes that explain a collection of variables. This structure describes the relationship between the latent variables and the observed variables. What you have collected from the respondents, this is called the observed variables. And also, these particular observed variables include some items. What you have collected using questionnaire, whether it is structured questionnaire or no unstructured questionnaire, suppose you have used some scales of measurement using on the basis of structured questionnaire or closed-ended questions, then after collection of some items, you have to identify the particular variable, how many items were included in the particular variables, and from the variables, then some latent variable will be created through exploratory factor analysis. That means exploratory factor analysis is very, very important for the identification of the important observed variable, which can be explained for the interrelationship between the variables, and also create a latent variable, and the particular latent variable actually affect the observed variables. At the same time, there may be a unidirectional and bidirectional causality. This means observed variable may affect the latent variable or latent variable may affect the observed variable. In this way, we can understand which factors and which variables actually are interrelated, which may affect the affect the dependent variable, our outcome variable, significantly. Okay, I'm starting from the research question because most of the participants are coming from the educations. I have taken the research question of education. I have already mentioned the COVID-19 pandemic actually affecting the education sector, disrupted the education sector dramatically, notably. That means my research question, which factors influence teachers' use of different functions and capabilities of e-learning environment? Actually, most of the teachers, about 100% teachers actually converted their education challenge by using online platform, online teaching learning mode. Therefore, different function and capabilities, that because if you consider the school teachers, they are not capable, they are not able to use the particular software. Therefore, training is needed in different cases. What I have seen from newspaper or media, and also on some TV channels, also some government introduces some software, some channels for teaching and learning system through online, through TV or different software. Therefore, obviously, this question was raised in my mind, which factors influence teacher use of different functions and capabilities of e-learning environment, because we are all teachers. Therefore, the factors, maybe I have gone through some literatures in education subjects. I have seen that some factors across the globe regarding internet facilities, because other than advanced countries, you will see that the internal facilities are not available around India. If you consider the West Bengal, if you consider the other states of India, internet facilities are not available, especially in the rural area. I have already mentioned just about near to 17% are available internet facilities, because internet facilities are important. Number two, cost is important, because you have to teachers have to use different software, internet facilities. Therefore, cost is very important. Or in case of student, cost is also important. Smartphones, I have already mentioned, about 35% students have smartphone, and also teachers, all the teachers have smartphone. PPT presentation, all the teachers are not able to present in PowerPoint mode. Online platform, each and every online platform is not available to everybody, because government support is not there. Video conferencing is not also there, especially in India. Audio is not properly functioning in most of the cases because of lack of internet facilities. Course material sent to email, but this course material has been sent to students by teachers. This is very good. Share whiteboard. If you use Zoom software or other software, teachers have used white software, and also online discussion. These I have found some factors. And I would like to mention that which factors actually in West Bengal, in other states of India, or across India, which factors are actually important, which latent, these are the latent variables, which factors and internet facilities include some variables, and these some variables include some items. Therefore, when you collect some data from the respondents, you have to remember, you have a theory, because you have to collect some internet facility, availability of internet facilities related questions. You have to create and collect data. And obviously, there may be a research problem, because my discussion is on exploratory factor analysis. Therefore, the which variables to include, the internet facility cost, smartphone, these are the factors according to the theory, across the globe. And which variables to include, that means which variables are important for explaining the relationship between the online education and online platform and pandemic period. How many variables are important? How our variables are measured? And also the sample size is important. Obviously, factor analysis to identify the particular variables, to identify the measurement, to know the ultimate factors. Factor analysis is very, very important for examining the relationship between the variables in terms of in determining the socioeconomic status, behavioral patterns, and psychological skills. Because during the pandemic period, our socioeconomic status, including education, behavioral patterns have been changed, and also psychological impacts are there. Obviously, psychological states are very, very important. For this purpose, a factor analysis is very, very important. For other students, I have created another research question, because during the pandemic period, our behavior regarding the purchase have been changed. Because most of the people are not interested to purchase non-essential item. They are basically use their hard-earned money, saved money, only for the essential goods. Therefore, buying behavior have been changed. Also, the savings behavior also changed. But I'd like to mention the buying behavior actually influence the purchase decision, because most of the people are not interested to purchase the non-essential item. Therefore, to identify the behavior of the consumer, behavior of the people, therefore some factors I have mentioned here: security, safety, quality, performance, value, technology, demographics are important variables, important factors. These may be identified through exploratory factor analysis. Now, what is factor analysis? Actually, factor analysis is a collection of statistical methods. Factor analysis is just like a multivariate independence techniques to analyze patterns. Actually, factor analysis is nothing but a correlation, and reduce large number of variables to a smaller number of components or factor. Because when we collect data or create questions, for collecting the data from the respondents, some overlapping variables are there. Therefore, the reduction of ultimate variable, important variables, to identify the important variables, factor analysis is important. And also, the factor analysis actually identify which variables are highly correlated, independent. At the same time, factor analysis actually, because factor analysis determined the latent factor, therefore, exploratory factor analysis actually explores the observed data for the presence of theoretical variables, and lastly, test of hypothesis. And this factor analysis can be classified into two groups. This is exploratory factor analysis and confirmatory factor analysis. Exploratory factor analysis actually is used when you have no theory. You want to just identify the variables, identify the particular variables with that are correlated, and also to determine whether there are any latent factor, to identify the latent factor. But there are no established theory. This is exploratory factor analysis. And confirmatory factor analysis is used. You have a theory. That means you have got established theory across the globe or around India in terms of different subject. In case of education, I have already mentioned, I have found some theory. Therefore, when we test the particular theory, which variables are, which latent factors or which variables are related or support the theory, in that case, you have to use confirmatory factor analysis. Otherwise, you have to use exploratory factor analysis because you have no prior theory. Therefore, exploratory factor analysis is just only for the identification of the interrelated variables. And these interrelated variables that may be observed variables, and out of observed variables, you may identify the latent variable. And basically, factor analysis examinations, I've already mentioned the items and different things. And type of factor analysis is also other also there. R type factor analysis. Particular correlation matrix to identify the important significant variables and to identify the latent variables, then R factor analysis you have to use. Other than if you want to use the covariance matrix, then you have to use Q type of factor analysis. And R type of factor analysis is very, very popular because we are basically use the correlation matrix for examining the interrelated variables through exploratory factor analysis. Now, how will you proceed factor analysis? In most of the cases, before going to the process, I would like to mention that there are differences between the principal component analysis and exploratory factor analysis, because most of the scholars, students, and academicians actually cannot differ the principal component analysis and
exploratory factor analysis, because two things are different. Because principal component analysis, there are no measurement factor, measurement error. But in exploratory factor analysis, there exists a measurement error. This is the important factor, because this is the important point for the distinction between the principal component analysis and the exploratory factor. How we proceed? First, you have create a research problem. I have mentioned the research problem is which factors actually influences the teacher's use of functions and technologies, teacher's use of technologies during the period of e-learning environment in times of COVID-19. And type of factor analysis, I have mentioned two types, exploratory and confirmatory factor analysis. You have to use exploratory factor analysis for when there is, you have no prior theory. And also exploratory factor analysis is two types, because R type and Q type. R type is most popular because we use correlation matrix. And component analysis means the factor analysis. Before going to that, it is necessary to discuss about which variables should be included in the exploratory factor analysis. I have mentioned the measured means the observed variables, what you have collected, from the respondents. These measured variables should adequately represent the domains of the factors, are thought to tap and not include variables from unrelated domains. That means any unrelated domains, unrelated items should be excluded. I can say an example. If you consider the domain of reading, you want to analyze the domain of reading. There exist multiple variables and that measure each dimension. Say for example, phone awareness. You may consider the vocabulary, you may consider the comprehension, or you may consider the phonics should be selected. But it would be inappropriate if you consider some other items. These variables should be considered, should be included. And before inclusion, you have to test or examine the validity. Examine the validity and reliability of the particular questionnaire and as well as the data. If the data is reliable, you may consider the particular data set or questionnaire. Otherwise, you have to remove it or include some new variables, some new questions. And again, you have to collect for this purpose pilot study. You have to use pilot study after collection of some data for examining the reliability and validity, internal validity, not external validity, internal validity. For reliability, you may use Cronbach alpha parallel analysis or different types of items analysis. If you consider the internal validity, you have to null and alternative hypothesis means the type one error. If type one error are just, I would like to mention
that the when the particular hypothesis which is true but rejected, then it is called type 1 error. And for this case, you have to use a type 1 error in alpha. At the same time, you use each of Cohen-Kappa test for validity whether your data is valid or reliable. For this purpose, you have to use the Cohen-Kappa test. If these are okay, then you may use the particular variables, particular questionnaire, particular questions. Now, which type of participants you may include? You have to careful about how many participants. You have to consider the logic and also the common sense. Does the sample of participants make sense given the construct that are being measured? You have to apply. Is the sample representative of the population of interest? That means before, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Collecting the data, you have to consider the target population, and you have to determine the sample size using different formula. Yamane's formula, Cochran's formula, Mackinnon formula, different formula. You have to determine the sample size. And after determining the sample size, you have to ensure that whether the sample representative actually indicates the population of interest. And then measurement error. You have to consider the measurement error. Measurement errors are considered in principal component analysis, but it is considered in exploratory factor analysis. Measurement error actually decreases the reliability of the variables and decreases the correlation between the variables. But it is very, very important in exploratory factor analysis because you could not consider measurement error. Obviously, there exist multicollinearity. Therefore, measurement error is very, very important for decreasing the multicollinearity. whether the correlation value, whether correlation value should be less than 0.80 or less, but more than 0.30 for determining the exploratory factor analysis. Again, I can say in terms of reliability, you have to consider the, if you consider the Cronbach alpha, then have to consider Cronbach alpha value 0.70 or more. If you consider Cohen-Kappa methods for validity, and then it should be more than 0.40, and thereafter you have to consider the type 1 or type 2 error. Type 1 error is very important in case of creation of hypothesis, because the true hypothesis will be rejected, and therefore it is very, very important for every researcher. And thereafter, you have to consider some methods, process. The process is common factor analysis. Process is extraction method, orthogonal and oblique rotation methods. Thereafter, you have to consider the factors before rotating, and after that rotating factors, and thereafter interpretation of the factors scores for the purpose of regression analysis or discriminant analysis. Now I am coming to the meaning of terminology. What is meant by the term factor? I have already explained the meaning of factor is a dimension that consists of any number of variables. Factor analysis involves extracting one factor, then evaluating your data for the existence of additional factors, and successive factors extracted in factor analysis are not of equal strength, because and thereafter the factor's strength, which is called the loading, will be lesser than the first one. Second one, factor excuse me, loading.
Sir. Excuse me, sir. Your screen is not visible. Your screen is not visible to us.
Oh. I'm sorry, again. I have to start again.
After the slide of the process,
Again, I'm starting the...
The meaning of factor
is,
portion.
Is it coming up?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Is it coming? Is it?
No, sir. No, sir.
Now?
No, sir. Sir, skin, your skin, yes, you're visible.
Now, is it visible?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir. It's coming.
Is coming.
Okay.
Yes.
Oh. This is meaning of terminologies. Before, correct. Factor loading. Factor loading is very important. Factor. What is factor loading? Factor loading is basically the correlation coefficient between. Variable and the correlation coefficient, then the Pearson coefficient means observed variables and unobserved variable, which is called the factor, is called the factor loading. Actually, factor loading shows the variance explained by the variable on the particular factor. I have already explained, because some variables create one factor, then those variables, say for example, three or four variables create one unobserved variable, which is called a factor. And the factor loading of the particular variable, three, four variables, actually explained the a particular factor. This is called factor loading. And in order to determine the dependent variable, if you consider the dependent variable constituting a common factor, and factor loading will be constituted. At the same time, suppose you have seen a positive factor loading. Positive factor loading means actually variables and factors are positively related. Factor, again, I am telling you, it is called the latent variable, unobserved variable. Now coming to eigenvalues, coming to the eigenvalues. What is eigenvalues? Eigenvalues are nothing but a characteristic roots, characteristics roots of the factor loading. Because when you have a got already, you have already, suppose you have got the factor loading, if you just square root of the factor loading, then it is called the eigenvalues. And eigenvalues actually shows the variance explained. Variance means the difference explained by the particular factor out of the total variance. Suppose you have considered 30 variables and created 8 factors, and 3-4 variables created 1 factor, and there are some variance. And if you sum total the total the sum of the variances, this is called total variance, total differences between the variables, then actually eigenvalue shows the variance explained by the particular factor, let any variable, out of the total variances. And eigenvalues is a good factor, good criteria for determining which variables will be retained, which variables will be removed from your factor, from your data analysis, and which variable, which latent variables will be included. Actually, for this purpose, eigenvalues is very, very important. Now, coming to the factor scores. Factor scores is called the component score. I have mentioned in the earlier site. Because in SPSS, if you use SPSS, then it is called the component. Otherwise, it is called the factor. Actually, factor score is nothing but an index. Factor score is just like an index of all variables can be used for further analysis. That means if you want to analyze the particular independent variables, whether there exist any impact of independent variables on the dependent variables, then you may use regression analysis, discriminant analysis, cluster analysis, then these factor score can be used for further analysis. Just factor analysis is nothing but an index of all variables. Now coming to measures of sample adequacy or anti-image correlation matrix. Anti-image correlation matrix is the reverse of the partial correlation coefficient. Just the reverse of partial correlation coefficient. Now, what is partial correlation coefficient? Suppose you have 30 variables, but partial correlation coefficient means you want to know the correlation coefficient between two variables. And in that case, remaining 28 variables will be constant. And in that way, you will get the partial correlation coefficient. And the partial correlation coefficient, the reverse of partial correlation coefficient, means if you consider the negative of partial correlation coefficient, then it is called anti-image correlation matrix. And anti-image correlation matrix actually indicates how strongly one item is correlated with other item. Means one variable is correlated with other variable, and the cutoff value is more than 0.50, but more than 0.70 is very, very important. The diagonals of the correlation, anti-image correlation coefficient, if it is more than 0.50 or near to 1, then it is called our sampling. Our sampling method is accurate. Our sample is adequate to explain the relations, interrelationship between the variables. We can easily determine the impact of the independent variables on the dependent variables. Now coming to the scree plot. Scree plot is a diagram. On the basis of diagrams, scree plot actually indicates which factors, how many factors will be retained, how many factors will be retained in the exploratory factor analysis. Then it is called scree plot. Scree plot are just like a diagram. This diagram is a elbow shaped diagram. If you consider the your elbow, then up to elbow from your particular hand, between the steep slope of the large factor and the gradual trailing of the rest up to the elbow will be considered and will be considered as factors, and thereafter the remaining factors will be removed from the exploratory factor analysis. Now rotation of factor. Rotation of factor is very, very important in exploratory factor analysis. After getting the factor loading, we have to interpret. We have to interpret because they are somewhat ambiguous. Because how many factors will be retained after rotation? And in that case, lots of rotation methods are available. We have to consider main two rotation methods, orthogonal rotation and oblique rotation. And orthogonal rotations are different types, and also oblique rotations are different types. When factors or variables are not correlated, then it we may use orthogonal rotation method. When if you determine, if you're sure about the particular theory, the factor and the variables are correlated, then you have to mandatorily use the oblique rotation method. And under under orthogonal rotation method, this is most popular because exploratory factor analysis is used when there is no theory. Only you have to determine, identify the variables, significant variables, and the latent factors. Now, for this purpose, easily we can determine, we can easily understand that our we have no theory, our variables and factors are not correlated. Therefore, orthogonal rotation will be used. This is strictly mathematical, but I can say it includes lots of rotation methods, but Varimax rotation method may be used. And in orthogonal rotation, Varimax, under orthogonal rotation, Varimax rotation actually perpendicular shape. You may use the diagram, you may use the graph, then the quadrant will be divided into four parts. If you consider the quadrant one, then X and Y values both are positive, and orthogonal rotation, all the variables will be rotated through 90 degree angle, and each angle actually each time 15 degree will be rotated in this way. 90 degree perpendicular line will be considered, and thereafter Varimax rotation will be considered, and thereafter we have to consider the rotated factors loading for examining the exploratory factor analysis for determining the important or significant variables. Before going to the analysis part, again, I want to mention what are the purposes of exploratory factor analysis. I have already mentioned development of psychometrics, measures. You can see it in case of confirmatory validation. When validation, because you have a theory, then validation is necessary, mandatory. But reduction of variables, because you have considered lots of variables, most of the variables may be overlapping variables, or therefore reduction of variables are necessary. You want to know the relationship between the variables. The interrelationship, you want to measure the interrelationship. And now I am coming to the analysis part. Before analysis, analyze the exploratory factor analysis EFA model. You have to know when you consider the questionnaire, structured questionnaire or survey method, your scales of measurement should be interval or ratio. Interval scale you have to use for collecting primary data. You may use secondary data or ratio scale you have to use. When we consider the sampling method, random sampling, you have to mandatorily use random sampling method, means random sampling, simple random sampling with replacement, or simple random sampling without replacement, you have to use. And thereafter, you have to determine the sample size using Cochran's formula or using Yamane's formula or using MacKinnon's formula. If your population is infinite, you may use Cochran's formula, or if your population, target population is finite, then you may use Cochran's formula, maybe used Yamane's formula, maybe used MacKinnon's formula. But if your infinite population, if your population is not finite, then it is better to use Cochran's formula for determining the sample size. And now your relationship between observed variables must be linear. And each observed variables, what you have considered, should be normally distributed. It is not mandatory. If it is normal, your results will be better. Better for explaining the interrelationship between the variables. You have to consider the bivariate normal distribution, or each pair of observed variables you may consider. You may consider multivariate normality, but mainly in case of confirmatory factor analysis, multivariate normality is used. But in case of exploratory factor analysis, you have to use the univariate or maybe bivariate normal distribution method. Now I'm coming to the differences between EFA and PCA, means most of the researcher, academician, teachers actually cannot differ the two methods, principal component analysis and exploratory factor analysis. Exploratory factor analysis is based on lots of method, maybe based on principal component analysis is very, very important. But if you want to use the measurement error, and measurement error is very, very important. And if there exists measurement error, you have to use the principal component analysis. But two methods have some similarity. Two methods are used for reduction of number of variables. Two methods are used on the basis of covariance or correlation matrix. Two methods will be based on linear model. Two methods are used for determining the factors or latent factors, but without rotation. But in an exploratory factor analysis, rotation is very, very important. And differences, I can say, I have already mentioned, principal component analysis starts with operating on linear low dimensionals and ends with a linear model. For this reason, it is called the descriptive technique. But exploratory factor analysis actually is based on basically the loading around the basis of factor loading, and it should be linear mandatorily. It should be homostochastic. There should not be multicollinearity problem, because if error, it should be considered. Exploratory factor analysis should be considered the error terms. Error terms means the measurement error. Actually, measurement error two types. Number one, random error, and number two means the
Hello, sir. Do you have any problem? Hello, sir. No sound, no video.
Sir, mone beriye geche.
Technical problem. It is technical problem. Is it of
স্নানের জল কখন বসাবো বলিস?
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Yes, we can't hear anything.
We are trying to contact sir. He is not. His phone is ringing, but he is not taking a call.
Okay. So we should be in a meeting, na? We should not leave.
No. You should not leave. Please be there. We are trying to contact him. I think some technical problem is there from his part.
Okay. But there was a very nice session was going on.
Really very nice session. But
very nice session. Very nice. And the thing I'm patronized is very nice.
Yes, really.
Please send me this YouTube link also so that we can see this in later on.
দেখতে যেতে সুবিধা হয়েছে খেলনা তুলেছিস খেলনা তুলে দে প্লাস্টিকের ভিতরে বিছানাটা চাদরটা একটু টান করে দে
Participants, please wait. We cannot contact sir. We are trying to contact him continuously. So please wait for 5 or 7 minutes. And we are trying to contact him. And at last, if he cannot join, we will share his PPT to you. So please give us some time. We are trying to contact the speaker.
Okay. Thank you.
Oh, sir came. Sir came. I think sir came. Sir, are you there?
Am I audible?
Yes, sir, audible.
Yeah, yeah.
You left the meeting for some reason.
Yes, sir, audible. It's not your face. Sir, you're not your face.
Oh. Where from? From which slide?
You are sharing screen.
Stop sharing. Your host will stop. It has been stopped. Disconnected.
Oh.
Actually, this is not my problem. Your problem.
Okay. Sir, can you see screen share problem? Is there?
Screens. Okay.
We cannot see anything, sir.
Again, I am sharing.
Okay.
Where from?
Sir, we were at the assumption of EFA. Assumption of EFA.
linearity.
Yes.
I have explained.
Yes, yes.
Where from?
What? HM's and last is in term of
sir, yes, you are visible. Yeah, EFA model.
Sir, you will continue from difference EFA between model. EFA and PCA.
EFA and PCA. Okay, okay, okay. EFA and PCA.
Yes, sir, from the distance.
And from this slide. From yes, this slide.
Yes, sir, the okay. Point number three.
Mama me phone
the component yes, sir, analysis violates the assumption of uncorrelated error terms, since the error terms are linear combinations of eigenvectors which do not belong to the selected linear no dimensional subspace. What do you mean by the term? Because both EFA and principal component analysis actually considers the linearity, means if the variables are linear, you may consider the PCA or EFA analysis. But in PCA analysis, no measurement errors are considered. No measurement errors are considered. Say, for example, what is a measurement error? If you consider what is a random error, if you consider when you collect the data from the respondents, suppose you have used Likert scale on the basis of agreement, strongly disagree, strongly agree, 5.5 point scale. Suppose you used Likert scale on the basis of satisfaction. From not at all very happy to very happy, 5 point scale, maybe 7 point scale. Suppose your respondents, you have created some questions. One respondent answers a particular items. And the same respondents does not pick close-ended question in other items. May I clear? Suppose you have mentioned two items, two questions. One is positive question, other is negative question. Say, for example, during the COVID-19 period,
sir, we cannot hear you. Sir. Sir, we cannot hear you. Hello. Sir, we cannot hear you.
Oh, hello. Am I able?
Yes, now
sir,
you are
we can't hear you.
Sir, your voice is breaking.
प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. हेलो
सर, आवर टेक्निकल पर्सन विल शेयर द स्क्रीन.
या
ओके.
ये मेरा प्रॉब्लम है.
ओके, द टेक्निकल टीम प्लीज, यू आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू शेयर द स्क्रीन.
Yes. Next slide. Hello. No. Okay, I'm a discussion. If birds are species, one question was raised earlier. What am I audible?
Sir, your voice is actually breaking.
Your PowerPoint is visible. Your audio is breaking.
Now,
sir, please use the microphone so that we can hear you clearly. Hello. Sir, please use the microphone. Sound is not clear, sir. Sound is not clear. Voice is cracking.
Okay, why? Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Right now you are audible.
Okay. One question was raised earlier. What are the differences between principal component analysis and exploratory factor analysis? Am I clear again? I'm telling you, am I clear?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Audible, okay.
Yes.
Actually, in principal component analysis, no measurement error is considered, but in exploratory analysis, measurement error is considered. Now, what is the particular term error? Why consider exploratory analysis and why it is not considered in principal analysis? I am asking you, in when you collect, when a research
the data from the land. Say for example, two questions in the same area. Say for example, online education. During the COVID period,
Sir, can't hear anything.
Can't hear.
Sir, the voice is too much breaking.
Am I? Am I audible? Hello, am I audible?
Sir, sometimes the voice is breaking.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir, slightly.
Slightly, why? My network is properly running. One second. Hello. Now am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Without using the earphone. Can I continue?
Sir, you may off your... You may off your video because of video it also creates problem.
Okay. Now, am I audible?
Yes. Fully clear now.
Okay.
Hmm.
What I was saying about the difference between principal component analysis and exploratory factor analysis. Suppose your question. Is are you happy with online education? Suppose you have used the Likert scale, a 5-point scale from not at all very happy to very happy. Okay. Suppose one respondent put tick in very happy, and at the same time, in that same respondent, you have raised another question. Are you happy about your smartphone or internet facilities? Then they have considered they tick, they put the particular respondents put the tick in not at all very happy. This is a problem of error. This is called the random error. And in principal component analysis, actually, these particular error is not considered in principal component analysis. But in exploratory factor analysis, what you have got from the respondent, you mentioned you have considered all data with errors. with measurement errors, with random error, with a non-systematic error. This is the main difference between the two principal component analysis and exploratory factor analysis. But in both the cases, we have to consider in exploratory factor analysis, whether it is a principal component analysis, in both the cases, you have to consider the linearity, whether the data is linear or not. If the data is not linear, you cannot use exploratory factor analysis or principal component analysis. That means that you have to check the linearity. Second, you have to consider the normality. Normality is not mandatory for exploratory factor analysis or principal component analysis. If the data is normal, and you have to check the normality using Kolmogorov Smirnov test or Sapiro-Wilk test, or also other Anderson-Darling test or Jarque-Behra test, or maybe use a Skewness-Kartosis test. Okay. Then you may use normality. If the data is normal, your results in factor analysis will be better for explaining the interrelationship between the observed variable or false or determining the latent factor. And then homoscedasticity. Homoscedasticity means the differences. That means the particular variable mean and variance of the particular data, particular variables are not constant. Then it is called heterostatic. If mean and variance are constant,
Hello, sir. Please tell us next to the technical team, because they are not understanding when they have to change slide.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I am sharing. Please permit your host. Hello, host.
Okay. Technical team, sir is telling that he will share the screen. Please allow him. Is it possible?
Yes.
Sir, you try.
Yeah. Is it Dr. Sur?
Yes, sir. Yes, now visible. Yes, now visible.
Okay, thank you. The difference is the principal factor analysis. But PCA actually optimizes the total variance, but not reproduce the correlation matrix. Measurement errors are considered. Come to the point of estimation, how will you exploratory factor analysis? Correlation matrix, correlation. And after correlation matrix, after considering the correlation matrix, you have to consider the three plot, variance explained and communalities. And these three conditions are to be considered: communalities, variance explained, and three plot. And then factor loading factor loading and extraction method. Extraction method principal component analysis is very useful, is more popular in exploratory factor analysis, but you may use principal axis or maximum likelihood method, unweighted least square or weighted least square method. But in rotation, when you want to consider the orthogonal rotation method, when the variables and will be considered for interpreting the factors, interpreting the latent variables. Now coming to the point, how factors are rotated. Because you have no theory, or there is pre-existing model. Therefore, principal component analysis, exploratory factor analysis on the basis of principal component analysis. Principal component analysis criteria to determine the extraction of then you have to consider which variables and which factors, which variable and variance pre-test and variance extent. You have to consider in the part EFT analysis. Am I audible? Dr. Shur, am I audible?
Yes, your voice is breaking, sir, continuously actually.
Now, am I audible?
Yes, now.
Okay. Before performing exploratory factor analysis, first you have to consider whether the data suitable for factor analysis or not. For this purpose, you have to check the linearity. You have to check the linearity. You have to check the normality. You have to check the homoscedasticity. Now linearity, how to check linearity? Because linearity, why check linearity?
But according to the book, is more than 500 or 2000. But in research, it will be it is only 50. If it is more than 50, then you may use Kolmogorov Smirnov test. If it is less than 50, you have to check Sacco will test. Otherwise, you may use Kuhn's test. If Kuhn's value is between -1.96 to 50.96, then you may use skewness value for normality. But normality is not mandatory. Now, homoscedasticity, what is homoscedasticity? Homoscedasticity means whether the variance and the mean are constant. If the mean and variance are constant, then it is called homoscedastic. If it is not constant, then it is called heteroscedastic. Then you have to check the homoscedasticity. Okay, how will you check? I will show you through my computer. Please, am I audible? Dr. Shur, am I audible?
Sir, you just continue, sir.
Okay, okay. Two, 3 minutes because I will start my SPSS. Okay.
Okay.
Hey, Ethan, dao to. Hey. Why mouse that out? Please wait. I will start SPSS. Please wait. Please wait. I will start SPSS.
Hello, sir. Can I ask a question, sir?
Yeah. Please.
Sir, regarding, sir, normality, generally we go for the Smirnov test, for the variable test in normality. But the thing is that, sir, actually I am working on the empirical data on 5-point Likert scale. So yeah. most of the respondents are giving 4 and 5. So in this case, it is forming a tail. So it is not getting a normal. So how we can tackle this thing?
Actually, normality is not mandatory if you use exploratory factor analysis. Again, I am telling you, normality is not mandatory for using exploratory factor analysis. If the data is normal, then you will get the better result. But how will you convert the particular data in normal form? Please use log 10 to the base 10 of the particular data, number one, then data will be normal. And if it is not normal by using logarithm method, then you have to use square root of the particular data for each and every numerical figure of the particular data, square root, then the particular data will be normal. Again, if the second method fails to convert the particular data into normality, then you may use the standard deviation of the particular data
standard deviation of the particular data, then
yes,
it will be normal. It is compulsorily normal. Okay, then okay, you will get the better result. But again, I am telling you, in exploratory factor analysis, normality is not mandatory. But for getting the better result, if the data is normal, you will get the better result. You may use the particular data for regression purpose, for discriminant analysis, canonical analysis, or further analysis or other regression method. Okay.
Yes, yes. Regarding sir EFA, suppose Parshuram et al.
Please don't ask questions now. Let him complete the session. At last, you will ask.
Okay.
Sir, are you ready?
Just starting my laptop.
Okay.
Please wait. Wait.
So in meantime, can I ask a question with sir if sir is comfortable?
Dr. Shur, please allow me.
Okay. Technical team, please allow him. Sir, please check. Now you can allow or not?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dr. Shur locked your host locked it. Hello. Dr. Shur, your host not allow me.
Sir, you are host now.
You cannot join this meeting now because the host locked it. Please unlock.
You are already in the meeting, sir.
Sorry?
Already you are in the meeting.
No. In another, I am using the laptop.
Oh, you are entering in another name.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh. Sir, in which name you are there?
Professor Amolendu Bhuya. Professor Amolendu Bhuya.
Okay. Sir, now can you share? Sir,
I've already.
Sir, any problem?
Yeah. Because your host cannot allow me.
But we have unlocked the room, sir. And no participant
again,
is waiting
trying,
here.
Again, I am trying.
Okay, you join.
No, no, no. Here, my computer shows that you cannot join this meeting. Dr. Shur.
Sir, you are not in the waiting room. I can see only Binoy Vishwas in the waiting room and Sanjeev Kumar in the waiting room. Your name is not showing in the waiting room.
Professor Amolendu Bhuya.
No, 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 Amolendu Bhuya is waiting in the waiting room.
My computer shows that you cannot join this meeting because it has reached the maximum number of participants allowed leave meeting.
But in the waiting room, there no name is there. In the participant list, those who are in the waiting room, your name is not there.
How? My name. Hello.
Hello.
My name.
Your name is not showing.
I am changing my name. AB only. AB. AB.
AB.
I am changing my name.
Okay. Let's check. No, sir. No, AB is there.
No, no. Wait. হচ্ছে লিক করে দিচ্ছে
sir. AB is joining
now. Yeah, now connecting.
Yes. Okay, sir, we are locking the room. Our technical team, please lock the room.
Okay.
Need gila to yaar.
Yeah. Okay. I host muted me. Dr. Shur, host muted
me. You have to unmute yourself. It's not possible from me to unmute you.
My screen is showing.
Yes, sir.
My screen is showing.
Sir, background music is coming. Sir, background sound is coming.
I think that you have to mute another device.
Sir, only you two, AB and Avalendu Bhuiya, only two are muted.
Okay.
Well, now continue, sir. Sir, continue.
Okay, I'm leaving from another site. I'm here. Now, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible, but video is not coming.
Okay, just wait. Now, yes, I have said the SPS screen.
Yes, now coming.
Is it?
Yes.
Okay. Data is visible.
Yes.
Data is visible.
Sir, you click the data.
Now SPS is.
You have not India data only. Cursor is there on India data.
Data is visible.
Only India data cursor is there. You have
data set. It is not.
You have to click that.
Is data set visible?
No.
Is data set?
No, no. Not
actually,
visible.
I'm staring. Data is visible?
No, no.
Now data set is visible. Each data set is visible. SPSS screen is visible.
Not yet. Let's check. It's buffering.
But you have screen in the screen.
No, sir.
I'm saying it's not visible.
No, sir, not visible.
Again, I'm sharing.
Oh.
Okay. Is data set visible? Actually, I'm sharing.
No. It's buffering.
Let Is it buffering?
Wait. Yes, buffering.
Okay. Data set is not visible. Now is it buffering?
Now nothing. Only screen is there.
Oh. Again, I'm stop. No.
Need to close the meeting and restart the meeting. It may.
Let's share the data with the technical team.
Is it visible?
No. Sir, you may share this data with us. We can share. You can mail me.
I have already sent you the data.
Okay. So the technical team, please share the data no. part. Sir, you stop screen sharing. Our technical team will do that. If you can't do that, then please stop. Our technical team, please share the data sheet screen.
Now is it visible?
Yes, sir. Now I think yes. Now you continue, sir, because time is going on. Already we have.
Hello.
Sir, please say something on your data sheet. Sir.
This is the Excel sheet, but SPSS. These data should be converted to SPSS software. Is there available SPSS in your host computer? SPSS available in your host computer? SPSS available?
No, right now it's not available. You have to speak on the basis of this data sheet.
Okay. Suppose. Okay, I'm starting again from the data. Suppose you have here 18 data, 18 variables I have considered here, but I have no prior theory. Therefore, we want to know which factors actually important for explaining the interrelationship between the education or socioeconomic status, say for example, and at the same time, which variables are important for explaining the interrelationship. For this purpose, exploratory factor analysis. You may use exploratory factor analysis, but before going exploratory factor analysis, first we have to check the data set whether the particular data is linear or not. For checking linearity, I do not know whether the participants have SPSS or not. If the participant have a SPSS software in your laptop or computer, then please use the particular data for the purpose of checking linearity. Please copy the particular data, or you may use your own data for checking the linearity. In SPSS software, you have to first paste the data for checking linearity. First paste the data for checking linearity. Then go to the variable view site. All the data are interval data. The first condition of exploratory factor analysis should be the data should be mandatorily interval data or ratio data. Here what you have seen, you can see the interval data based on Likert scale from 1 to 5 you have used. Actually, here 18 variables I have considered, and all the data are interval and like 3 point scale. Therefore, we may use exploratory factor analysis, first you have to check the linearity. And first you have to go SPSS software, analyze or checking linearity. How will you check the linearity? Am I audible? Please. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Whatever you have, you are audible or not audible, you just complete because we have to complete within 10 or 12 minutes.
Because I am showing only the data set, not SPSS software.
Okay.
Okay.
I am not able to
share the screen due to unavoidable circumstances. I am only showing the data. You may copy the data or you may use your own data for checking linearity. If you have SPSS software, please go to the SPSS. Click analyze. Click analyze. Then click pair means. After clicking analyze, then click compare means.
Yes. You just complete within 10 minutes, sir. Already we are running late.
Oh. Then compare means, click means. For checking linearity. You may see there are two box in the attendee list, in the participant list. One variable will be transferred to the dependent list and other variable will be transferred to the independent list. Then click option and you may see in option box, you may test for linearity. Then continue and okay. Then ANOVA table will come. In the ANOVA table, you will get the deviation from linearity. If the probability of the deviation from linearity is more than 0.05, then your particular data is linear. Otherwise, your data will not be linear. In that case, in this way, you have to check the linearity. Okay. Second, how to check the normality. Then go to analyze, click analyze, then click descriptive statistics, then click descriptive statistics. And then in the descriptive statistics, click. Explore. You may see there are two boxes in the dependent list box and in the factor list box. One variable will be transferred to the dependent list. And other variable transferred to the factor list. Then click plots. In the explore plots, click the normality plots with tests. And at the same time, you can check the homoscedasticity in just below the plot box. You may see the power estimation that is for Levens test. Power estimation, click the power estimation. Click the power estimation. Then continue and OK. Then continue and OK. You will get the homogeneity of variance and test of normality. And in test of normality, two test results will come. One is Kolmogorov-Smirnov and other is Shapiro-Wilk test. Because your sample size is more than 0, you have to consider the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test. If the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test, the probability means significance, the probability is more than 0.05, the data is normal. You please do not consider the Shapiro-Wilk test. If your data is less than 50, then you may consider Shapiro-Wilk, otherwise Kolmogorov for checking normality. If the data is not normal, then you may consider the particular data set. I have already explained the particular data set in the logarithm form or the square root form, then the data particular will be normal. But in exploratory factor analysis, there is no problem if the data is normality, you may proceed further. You have to check the homogeneity of variance. Levens test will come, Levens statistics based on mean. If the Levens statistics is more than, the probability is more than 0.05, then the particular data is homoscedastic. That means you may proceed further. In this way, you have to check the homoscedasticity. And after checking the normality, after checking the linearity, after checking the homoscedasticity, but linearity is mandatory. Normality is not mandatory. You have to consider sample size at least 10:1 and 300 sample size using the formula. Then I'm going to the exploratory factor analysis. In the SPSS box, please click analyze in your computer. In the data reduction, you see the data reduction in analyze box. Click the data reduction. You may see in the factor. Click the factor. Factor analysis will come. In factor analysis, there is no difference between the dependent variables and independent variables. Therefore, all the dependent and independent variables, based whether it is normal data or whether it is normal data or not, because the data is homoscedastic, because the data is interval. Because the data is interval and you have to consider the ratio at least 10:1, 20:1 sample size is better, sample ratio is better. Then first you have all the dependent and independent variables in the variable box, transferred to the variable box. In the factor analysis, you see the I box. In the click the descriptive descriptive factor analysis statistics, automatically initial solution automatically click tick. You have to put tick in the invariate descriptives. In the correlation matrix, click coefficient. in the correlation matrix, click NTH in the correlation matrix, click KMU and Bartlett test of sparsity. Then continue in the extraction method, automatically print component analysis, but in extraction method, automatically you will see the principal component analysis is the most popular method. Only in the display display side, in the extraction box, you have to tick the scree plot and then continue. And in the rotation method, another again, you have to click the rotation rotation point. In the method box, click the Verimax. Click the Verimax. Only the Verimax method under orthogonal rotation, automatically orthogonal rotation will come. Verimax, you have to tick the Verimax and then continue. And then again tick the score in factor. Sorry, I'm so sorry. In the factor score box, tick save as variables. Automatically method regression, automatically regression will come. You have to tick the display factor score coefficient matrix. You will tick the display factor score coefficient matrix. Then continue. Again, tick the option box. In the coefficient display format, in option box, you have to tick the sorted by size and suppressed value. Here, suppressed value 0.60 will be cut. That this indicates that less than 0.60 factor loading will automatically suppress. Then continue. Then now tick finally OK, and the factor analysis test result will come in the output box. First, you have to check KMO Bartlett test. KMO Bartlett test. And in the KMO Bartlett test, result come 0.733. KMO Bartlett test, the cutoff value of KMO Bartlett test is 0.60. If it is more than 0.60, automatically our sample is adequate for checking the exploratory factor analysis. You may continue with exploratory factor. Bartlett's test of sparsity, chi-square test value, the probability of Bartlett test of sparsity in terms of chi-square. If it is probability is less than 0.50, then you may proceed with exploratory factor analysis. Then you have to consider the anti-image matrix. Anti-image matrix, actually, I have mentioned the reverse of the partial correlation coefficient. First, you have to consider the diagonals of the anti-image correlation. If the diagonal value, correlation coefficient value of the diagonal matrix is 0.50 or more, then that means you may proceed with anti-correlation. That means anti-image correlation actually indicates that how strongly the variance can explain the relationship between the variables and factors. And then we have to consider the total variance explained. total variance explained is very important. How many factors and how many variables will be retained in exploratory factor analysis. And the cutoff value of the total variance explained is 60%. The cumulative percentage of the factor is 60%. And here come what I have seen after clicking it, 62.973%. That means it is more than 60%, and five factors will come. Five factors has already I have seen. That means the exploratory factor analysis consider five factors with percentage of variance. First factor, the percentage of variance is 18.433%, and the second factor, the percentage of variance 12.152%. Third factor, in this way it will be reduced, the percentage the percentage of variance will be reduced. The third factor, the percentage is 11.877%. Fourth factor, 706%. Fifth factor, a 9.805%. And again, in the total variance explained, you have to consider the eigenvalue. When eigenvalue is more than one, you have to consider the factors for retaining the particular factors. And what I have mentioned, five factor has already come out because the eigenvalue is more than one. And first factor, eigenvalue 3.898, what I have seen. Two, second factor in this way, 2.073. Third, 1.463, 4, 1.371, 5, 1.271. In this way, and the other factors is less than one. In this way, you have to consider the scree plot diagram. And when the in the scree plot, the elbow you have to come, then below five factor, the eigenvalues are less than one. And also the below of the elbow, then five factors will be five latent variables. has been five factor has latent variables have been incorporated in fact exploratory factor analysis. Then after considering the orthogonal rotation, Barimex rotation, what I have considered that the factors and variables are not correlated. Therefore, orthogonal rotation matrix, we have considered Barimex rotation method, and rotated matrix, you have to consider the final result, rotated matrix. And I have mentioned when in the score side, we have suppressed 0.60 factor loadings in modern research, 0.70 you may consider. Means factor loading less than 0.60 will be automatically will not be considered. In first, there are five factor in rotated component matrix, and there are factor loadings in first factor. There are three variables in second factor. There are three variables in third factor. There are two variables in fourth factor. There are two variables in fifth factor. There are two variables. In this way, 12 variables out of 18 variables. Out of 18, I have considered 18 variables. But after rotating the factors and considering the factor loading, there are 14 variables and 5 latent factors have been incorporated. And in this way, rotated component matrix, you have to finally selected in your research paper, and there are only 12 variables. And thereafter, you have to incorporate the name of the five latent variable. This means 12 variables are correlated, but not multicollinearity. There is no multicollinearity problem. The factor loading, whose factor loadings are more than 0.60, it will be considered. And these 12 variables and 5 factors, you have to incorporate the names of the variables, and also finally you have to consider the communality value. Communality means how strong the strong the variance explained by the factors, and when it is, and how the variables as well as the factors what you have selected, 5 factors have been incorporated. After factor analysis, if the communality's value is more than 0.50, then it will be considered. Otherwise, the particular variable will be removed from the exploratory factor analysis. In this way, what I have seen, in the 12 variables, after rotating the factors, 12 communality's values are more than 0.50, and the variance explained about 63%, and the eigenvalues are more than 1 in case of 5 factors. Therefore, after factor analysis, considering the exploratory factor analysis, in this way, the variables have been reduced out from 18 variables to 12 variables, and at the same time you have got the 5 factors, five latent variables for further analysis. In this way, how will you interpret? You have to interpret the factors, you have to interpret the variance explained, you have to interpret the eigenvalues in the research paper, you have to interpret the C plot, you have to interpret the KMO and Bartlett test result. In this way, first starting from the descriptive statistics, and in the descriptive statistics, when you have considered 18 variables whose mean is highest, you may consider the particular variable is mostly important for explaining the impact of the independent variable on the dependent variable. And in this way, again, you have to consider the KMO Bartlett test, KMO results, because the KMO result is more than 0.70, comes out 0.73. Therefore, you may consider your data is applicable for exploratory factor analysis, and the matrix is not an identity matrix. Bartlett test of sparsity support the particular KMO result, and our sample is adequate for explaining the interrelationship between the variables. And coming to you explain in the variable in your research paper factor loading, what I have mentioned, factor loading actually important, and you have to show the factor loading. You have to show the factor loading and how will you interpret. And first you have to interpret cutoff value according to the thumb rule. You have to write as per thumb rule of statistics, factor loading is more than 0.50 after considering the orthogonal Vmax rotation. We have got 12 variables, and the particular variables, the factor loadings of the particular, all the variables are more than 0.50. And in this way, first factor consists 3 variables. You have to incorporate name and
hello. You are not audible. Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello. Sir, you are not audible. And sir, time is also up. Sir, you are not audible.
Please, please. Five. Interpreting. Okay. How will you interpret? Please, please.
Okay.
Oh, within okay. 5 minutes, please.
Okay.
And
okay.
In this way, you have to reach the factor loading after considering the 5 factor and the variables. You have to explain on all the data and with factor loadings, and also you have to explain the particular variables affect are interrelated and also affecting the latent variable. Say for example, first factor name is internet facilities. Second factor name is say for example cost. Suppose you if your question is what is the cost of smartphone, what is the cost of internet, what is the cost of your education, then cost is the second factor, and these variables, these three variables are interrelated, and other variables have been removed from the factor analysis, and these variables affecting the cost. And in this, because all the variables are, all the factor loadings are positive, that means the cost is positively affecting the education cost in online education system. And in the third factor, if you consider the if you consider the pandemic economy, whether your economy affect the online education or not, then third factor name may be the economy or maybe society, whether the education society affect the education or not. In that case, suppose you have to consider, are you happy about the online system, whether are you happy about the teaching learning mode through online system, then these variables are interrelated, and these variables are affecting the society. In this way you have to explain the rotated factor, because what I have seen, all the factor loading are positive. Also, if there exist a negative factor loading, negative factor loading also consider rotated factor. In that case, the particular variable negatively affect the particular latent variable. You have to write this variable adversely affect the particular variable. That means in this way you have to write a rotated factor matrix, and thereafter you have to explain the eigenvalues and eigenvalues and scree plot. Eigenvalues are very, very important. After explaining the 5 factors and the variables, 12 variables, then you have to explain the eigenvalues. And eigenvalues actually indicates the characteristics of the roots, characteristics of the roots of the factor loadings. If the factor loadings are positive, obviously, the eigenvalues will be considered as positive. But in case of a negative square root, it will not be considered under eigenvalues. You have to write, because eigenvalues are positive. Positive, that the characteristics of the factor loadings are positive, and eigenvalues actually explain how strongly influence the 5 to the on the dependent variable. And in this way, last sentence I can say, you have to explain the percentage of variance, because percentage of variance is important. because percentage of variance is more than 60%, because cutoff value is 60%, you may explain, you may interpret in this way, the percentage of variance explain or indicates that our test results, our factors and variables are significantly interrelated, and also all the dependent and independent variables affecting the factors. In this way, you may explain that these factors, these variables influence the e-learning environment or virtual learning environment during the pandemic situation. And in this way, you have to use the exploratory factor analysis for the identification of the variables as well as the latent variables. This is the method of exploratory factor analysis, not principal component analysis. This is exploratory factor analysis on the basis of principal component method, extraction method using orthogonal rotation method. I am so sorry for not showing the SPSS. Please applaud. I am so sorry for the purpose of not showing the SPSS and not being able to show the SPSS software. Okay. Dr. Sur, am I audible?
Sir, have you completed your session?
Sir,
completed your session?
Yeah. Because now about
1.4
G.
yes, actually, due to some technical fault, there are some unnecessary problems occur in the midst of program, online program. And as we all know, it occurs occasionally in the online classes in our sector also. So
I understand why SPSS is not showing. Was not showing, I do not understand.
Okay, sir, this happens actually in online program. It happens. Yeah, these technical errors are always there. And this is that's why we prefer face-to-face mode learning. There is many facilities of online learning.
Sir, please share your PPT to the organizer member so that we can get your PPT, sir.
Yes, he had already shared.
Sure, you will get the PPT and all the results also from the data I have sent yesterday.
Yes, sir. Can we share it with the participants? Can we share it with the participants?
With the data set.
Okay, sir. I will share it in your mail. Participant, please keep patience. We will share it to your mail. Okay, and
what I have explained, what I on the basis of the results, you may automatically you have seen in my PPT. Okay, again, I am so sorry for the network issue, for technical problems.
No issue, sir. It was a very helpful session, sir, and we have a very less time, but it was very helpful. If we'll take more, then we can enrich more, sir.
Yes.
Okay.
Now.
Any question?
Sir, it's already 2 months late. So if they have any question, they can ask question in SMYBR 1920 in that email, and I will forward that mail questions to your mail. We don't have any time. Actually, we don't have any time. We have another program from 2. That's why we have to hurry up. So Thank you. Now it is the time for vote of thanks. I want to congratulate Dr. Amlendu Bhuiya, Professor, Department of Commerce, University of Kalyani, for managing his busy managing time for us from his busy schedule. We are really grateful to him for sharing such enriching data set and this factor analysis. So I think this will be very much helpful for the participant for their future research in any area, not only in the social science, but also in pure science and other area like management, commerce, economics. They can apply in any area, this factor analysis. So this is very much helpful for the participants as well as to us. So thank you, sir, for managing time. And thank you. Thanks to the principal, Dr. Uma Ghosh, Principal Siddhinath Mahavidyalaya, for organizing such beautiful program and for supporting me all along for organizing and conducting such beautiful webinars and workshops. And constantly, she always constantly encourages us to do such good things. Thanks, special thanks to Dr. Prathida Vishas, HOD, Associate Professor, Department of Education, School of Education, Adamak University, for her technical support and for her every support she has given me. Without her support, we cannot organize such webinars. Actually, we are organizing such webinars from 19th June 2020. And we will still go till 16th August. We have various programs. So thanks to her again. And thanks to the members of the, all the members of organizing committee and the advisory committee for helping us to organize this workshop. Last but not the least, thank you. Thanks to the participants that they have kept their patience. Even after some technical faults, they didn't lose their patience and cooperated us throughout the workshop. Even yesterday, we have faced some problem, and today also. Thank you to all the participants all over India. Thank you for your patience hearing. And there is a notice for the participants that the feedback link along with the two-day YouTube link, it will be given to your email. And sir has, Amulandi sir has also told that the data sheet and the PPT to share it with you. So it will also be shared to your mail. So please don't be impatient, because we will take some time, minimum 1 week, to send to your mail. And after clicking the feedback link, you will get certificate. But please at least give us 7 day time. Okay, and thank you, sir. Thank you again. And thanks to all the organizers and everyone, all each and everyone for such beautiful workshop. Okay. Sir, okay, can we leave the meeting?
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you.